गुड मॉर्निंग। राइट। राजेश सहदेव,
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग, यू कैन स्टार्ट।
ओके सर, माय टॉपिक इज डायरेक्ट मैनिपुलेशन। आई नीड टू टॉक अबाउट द थ्री पॉइंट्स ऑफ फोर पॉइंट्स ऑफ द डायरेक्ट मैनिपुलेशन। आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट दैट सर। इंटरेक्टिव सिस्टम्स जनरेट ग्लोइंग एंथुसियाज्म अमंग यूजर्स that is in marked contrast with the more common reaction of reluctant acceptance or troubled confusion. The enthusiastic users report the following positive feelings: that direct manipulations types are mastery of the interface, competitions in performing tasks, ease in learning originally and in assimilating advanced features, confidence in the capacity to retain mastery over time. Examples of direct manipulation is first one is word processor history and current status. It may be hard for users for today word processors to believe, but in the early 1980s, text editing was done with line oriented common language. Users might see only one line at a time. Typed commands were needed to move up or down through the file or to make any changes. The enthusiastic users of novel full page display editor were great advocates of their two dimensional interface with cursor controls. A typically comment was, once you have used to display editor, you will never go back to a line editor. You will be spoiled. Second example is the VisiCalc spreadsheet and its descendants. The first electronic spreadsheet, VisiCalc, was the product of a Harvard Business School student, Dan Bricklin, who became frustrated when trying to carry out repetition calculation for a graduate course in business. He and a friend built an instantly calculating electronic worksheet that permitted computation and immediate display of result. The spreadsheet can be programmed so that the sum of the values every time a value in one of the first three columns changes, the value in fourth column changes as well. Complex dependencies between, for example, manufacturing cost, distribution cost, sales revenue, commissions and profits can be stored for several sales distributors and for various months. Third example is office automation history. Designers of early office automation systems used direct manipulation principle. The pioneering Xerox staff offered sophisticated text formatting options, graphics, multiple fonts, and a high resolution cursor based user interface. Users could move a document icon to a printer icon to generate a hard copy printout. The Apple The Apple system also elegantly applied many of the principles of direct manipulation, although it was not a commercial success. So that's it.
Okay. Next. Next, Naina. Surya Prakash. Rajesh, Seema, Seema, still they're sleeping, I hope. Chintana?
Yes, sir.
I can tell you.
My topic is combination of multiple menus. Menus can be combined in linear series or can be pre-presented simultaneously. First point is linear menu sequence and simultaneous menu. Here, a series of interdependent menu can be used to guide user through a series of choice in which they can see a sequence of menu. For example, pizza ordering interface might include linear sequence of menu to choose size, like small, medium, large, and even thickness. It can guide the user through some complex decision-making process, like cue cards or wizards. Linear sequence guide user by presenting one decision at a time and are effective for novice user performing simple tasks. Simultaneous menu present multiple activity menu on a screen at the same time and allows user to enter choice in any order. Second point is tree structured menu. Here, when a collection of item grows and becomes difficult to maintain under intellectual control, designer can perform category of similar item to create a tree structure. Example like font, size, style, and spacing. If a grouping at each level are natural and comprehensible to the users, and if user know the target, then menu traversal can be accomplished in a few seconds. That means it could become faster. If groupings are unfamiliar, and then user might get lost for an hour in a tree menu. Terminology from the user task domain can help orient the user. Expanding the menu maintains the full context of each choice. Third point is menu maps. As the depth of the menu tree grows, user find it difficult to maintain a sense of position in the tree. Weaving one menu at a time makes it hard for user to grasp overall pattern and relationship among the category. So this menu map can help the user stay oriented in the large menu tree. Fourth point is acyclic and cyclic menu network. Here, network structure in the form of acyclic and cyclic graphs arise naturally in social relationship, transportation routine, and also the World Wide Web. As a user move from tree to acyclic network to cyclic network, a potential of getting lost increase, which might cause user confusion and disorientation for the user who have difficulty navigating the large cyclic network. That's it, sir.
At least over 5 minutes adana matadbekalumma. Okay. Next is Spurti. 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 Shashank.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I just start.
So my topic is content organization. So to create meaningful grouping and sequencing of menu items for the user to feel easy when he's organizing or when he's sequencing a set of data. So for that, we need to follow a set of guidelines or a set of rules for that. So first one is task-related grouping tree structures. So for that, under that, the first point will be create groups of logically similar items. So for example, when we are creating when we're creating a group, all the items should be similar to each other. For example, countries. So if you're mentioning countries under a group, there should be only country names. And the second one is form groups that cover all possibilities. So here we can give an example for age. So if you're mentioning age in the menu or in the form, it should range. We should also give a range for it. So for instance, 0 to 30. So 0 will be minimum and 30 will be the maximum. The third point will be make sure that items are not overlapping. So sometimes under categories in menus in categories when we specify the items, one or two items will be overlapping. So that should not be the case, so that the user won't be confused. And the fourth one is use familiar terminology. So but ensure that items are distinct from one another. So when we are specifying time, or when we're specifying a day, a night, afternoon, evening, we should mention the time also. So for instance, if it's morning, so it can be like 6 a.m. to 11 a.m. or 11:30 a.m. If it's afternoon, 12 p.m. to 4 p.m. like that. So it should be precise, and we should not we should make sure that we are specifying it particularly. So, and the next topic under this is item presentation sequence. So when you have to, when the user has to design a form, he has to present each and every information in a sequence. So for that, also there are certain items he has to include. For instance, time. So time, we include like first is hours, then minutes, then seconds, then milliseconds in chronological order. Then numeric ordering, that is either ascending order or descending order. Then physical properties, for example, temperature, then weight, then area, volume. Then then the other categories are alphabetic sequence of terms. So when we mention a set of terms or a set of words, they should be in alphabetical order. Then grouping of related items. So related items, when we specify something, all the when we specify a category, or when we mention a set of items, items which are similar should be categorized, so that there won't be any confusion. Then most frequently used items first. So whichever items or whichever data we use most frequently, that can be mentioned first. Then comes menu layout. So in menu layout, so when we design a form, we give a drop down menu, right? And under that menu, there's so much information. So for that, we also need to follow certain guidelines. So for that, we can use semantic to organize menu. That is single menu, linear sequence, tree structure, acyclic or cyclic networks. Then second point is prefer broad, shallow to narrow, deep. Then third point is use items as titles for subtrees. So we should also provide titles so that the user can know what exactly, what kind of data you're presenting. Then show position by graphics, numbers or titles. Then sequence items meaningfully. Then use brief items, begin with the keyword. Use consistent grammar, layout, terminology. So here, use consistent and precise phrasing. So, for instance, we're mentioning something like animals. So, under animals, we have to specify only the animal names. So, if you're specifying, if there's a drop-down menu called vegetables, so under vegetables, you have to specify only the names of the vegetables, not anything else. So, that's it, sir.
Masala.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Shashank, over. Spurti.
Present, sir.
Okay, I'm present.
Okay, sir. My topic is data entry with menus, form filling, dialog box, and alternatives. In the primary goal of menu form filling is, and the dialog box designer is to create a sensible, comprehensible, memorable, and convenient organization relevant to the user task. Form filling is primarily for data entry or data retrieval. Screen like paper form, data put in a relevant place requires good design. Obvious correction facilities. In form filling, a full complement of information is visible to user. Display resemblance, familiar paper forms. For few instructions are required for many types of entries. User must be familiar with keyboards, error correction methods, use of tab key or mouse to move the cursor, field label meanings, use of the entry and or return key, permissible field contents. Interaction to be there in the frameworks, their interaction frameworks framework has four parts: user input, system output. Each has its own unique language. Interaction translation between languages, problems in interaction equals problems in interaction. And menus are a set of options displayed on screen, visible, less recall, easier to use, relay on or recognition. So name should be meaningful, selected by using mouse, numeric or alphabet keys. Menu organization important, often option hierarchical grouped, organization relevant to task and use, organization must studied. Menu system can be purely text based with option presented as numbered choice, graphical selected by arrow keys, graphical selected by mouse combination, restricted from all the full WIM MP systems. That's it, sir.
That's all, huh?
Yes, sir.
Right. Next to Asha. Seema.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you can.
Okay. So my topic is single menu. Single menus require user to choose between two or more items, or may allow multiple selection. The simplest case is binary menu with, for example, yes, no, true, false, or male, female choice. Those simple menus might be used repeatedly. Example, in delete dialog box. So shortcuts are appropriate default behavior. Should be chosen carefully. A binary menu allows user to choose between two options, yes or no. The blue highlight in any question, there is some red button. So in some question, we have to choose only one option, and in some question, there is multiple like radio button or multiple options. It indicates that this selection is the default and the pressing button will be selected. Keyboard shortcuts are available and indicated by the huge underlined letters. When more than two items are present, for example, in a quiz display on a touch screen, User select an item to answer the question. Radio button supports single item selection from a multiple item menu. While check boxes allow the selection of one or more items in a menu, a multiple selection menu is a convenient selection method for handling multiple binary choice. Since the user is able to scan the full list of items,
what happened? Over. Seema? Not even 5 minutes, yeah? Huh? Surya? Nayana? Rajesh? Nazma?
Sir, just a minute, there are expense.
I'll
explain, sir.
You can tell. Which topic I have given for you?
Unique legal issues, sir.
No, you have told, no.
I told only half, sir, that time.
You have completed?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Anybody else?
Sir, Yashaswini, sir.
Yeah, tell me, madam.
Okay, sir. My topic is fast moving through menus. After optimizing the grouping and sequencing of a menu item and considering adaptable menu strategies, there are still technologies available to accelerate the movement through the menus, particularly for expert users. Next point, a standard way to permit frequent menu users to speed through the options is to provide the keyboard shortcuts. For example, an expert user might memorize that in Microsoft Word is a short word, the shortcut Alt-V for view followed by Alt-O for outline will change a document's presentation to the outline view. Even if the display of the menu item is very fast, the user will still avoid reaching for the mouse. Locating the correct option and reaching two targets with the mouse. This approach is attractive because it is rapid and allows graceful evolution from the novice to the expert. Next, time menus, marking menus, and other variations of circular menus can insert a short delay before menu items are displayed, allowing users to mouse ahead, relying on their mental memory to reproduce the series of angular displacements necessary for a command selection. For example, in drawing program, a click up, left up can start dragging an object before the menu appears. When unsure, users wait until the menu appears. Next, in web browsers, bookmarks provide a way for users to take shortcuts destinations that they have visited previously. For many users, this menu of destination can grow quickly and require hierarchical management strategies, becoming a challenge in itself. Another approach to serving the frequent menu users is to allow regularly used parts to be recorded by the users as menu macros or to be placed in the toolbar as user selected icon. User can invoke the macro or customization facility, traverse the menu structure, and then assign a name or icon. when the known or icon is invoked, the traversal is executed automatically. Next point. This mechanism allows tailoring of the interface and can provide a simplified access mechanism for repetitive tasks. Many word processor allows users to define their preferred character styles through multiple menu selections and then to name each of the style and to remember. WWW web browsers provide bookmarks for the quick access to specify pages. That's it, sir.
That's all.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Anybody else? Remaining people? Let's come on. Surya Prakash.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, now only back up, sir.
Yes,
sir. I give one topic, not to you.
Sir, that was...
Tell me. Yeah, you can tell, Sir Prakash.
Just a second.
Yeah.
Sir, you said you will give a new topic.
No problem, you tell that one only. What I give.
Expert reviews. Okay. Reviews, huh? So reviews are usually like feedback from an anonymous persons or any well reviewers who's usually a user who's expert in that field and is an expert in telling what the fault is. Usually we see these reviewers in YouTube, like mobile reviewers or car reviewers. They usually open the product and go through it for a week and suggest what the fault is or suggest what needs to be rectified in that, so that the product can be better when the next product comes out. That's it, sir.
Over, Not even 5 minutes, Surya Prakash.
Simple, sir. Short and sweet.
Okay, anybody else? Surya Prakash, go over. Naina? Naina is not there. Spurthi, go over. Varsha? Rajesh? Okay. All right. See, here theory subjects, you have to elaborately how to write it. If you write it one or two sentences, it will be difficult. See, when you are communicating, we'll be telling the key points, highlighted points. But when you are writing the examination, you have to write elaborately. Take more examples and write it that one. So, if you are writing half page, quarter page and all for 8 marks and all, nobody will give. So, interaction systems, we have told Sahadev, for example, Word, PPTs. So, previously what it happened, now what it happened. You take some more examples and make the boxes, alignment, left, right, so that you can write many examples, so spell check. So, all these things can be done. So, with the examples, you can explain it. That's what you have to drag the messages. Otherwise, what will happen, if you write it half page, they will also they'll give half of the marks. So, that is a drawback. What you have to do is, you have to write elaborately, otherwise it will be very difficult. That's what I want to say. Okay. You have to drag, that's all. No other option. Maybe repetitions will happen. Don't worry for that. You write it elaborately, the points. That's what I used to say, the professional communication examples, they'll say. So I gave you a pen to one person, let me say Surya Prakash. I gave you a pen to Surya Prakash. So Surya Prakash asked me when I was taking the class, Ada, so to, sir, I have forgotten, please can you give me the pen? So I gave you a pen, so I scolded him, something like that. So you can add yourself. So instead of telling the only the gave pen, so when I was taking the class, when I was using the blackboard, when I was teaching that particular topic, he has asked me to give pen. So that day I have given the pen. So other people were laughing. So and so people were sitting behind it. Neighbors, something like that, you have to drag that hand. Gave a pen is different. Now I told 78 sentences for the same syntax. So that's what you need to drag the messages. You have to fill the pages, that's all. UID is nothing but main heading, and you have to fill the pages, that's all. Otherwise, you will not get the marks, I'll tell you. So, you have the clarity for the definitions, but the similarly, you need to drag the messages. That is what you need to do it. You have to fill the pages also, that you keep in that mind, and you have to write it. So everybody has the capabilities. Only thing is you have to think and you have to write it. That's all. So at least programming means if I know the problems, if I know the algorithm, then I can be able to implement it. Here, once you remember the main headings, you can write it. That's all. So everything nowadays is very easy one. So Sahadev was telling 1950s, 60s, there by seeing computers only were a bit difficult. So 90s also, we used to go to colleges and we used to use the college system. Now what happened, you are able to offer the systems also. So you are having the systems, you can utilize all these things. So it is easy one, you know. So apart from that, whatever they were telling 60s and 70s online will come off all these things. Now you are using that. So that is the reason this subject is easy for you to understand. Nothing is there to understand because already you are using that. So only thing is you have to write the pages. That's what I want to say from my end. So tomorrow we'll discuss about the case study questions and the important questions for the test. And all of you try to write the examination for the third test. Some of the people are having first test bit less marks. Now you have the option to increase your marks, because anyway offline only, it's online only, so you can write the answers, you can take the marks. So otherwise we are helpless. Some of the people were option for the test, they don't have any option. Some of the people, they have written it. Some people, they have got less marks and all. So try to write it, nothing will happen. I am requesting all the people to write the examination, try to take good marks. Even if you have 36, 37, as a way, I'll get, I'm having 36, 37, no problem. That is more than that. Don't think that way. Try to get still more marks. This is the last chance to improve your percentage. So percentage, you know that what is important. So keep in that mind, try to write the examination. That's what from my end. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. Tomorrow we'll discuss the case study question and innovative question and the important questions for the, with respect to question papers, we'll see world question papers, what type of questions they can ask. That's what we'll see it. Okay. So now, answer your attendance. Two, three, four, five, six.
Present, sir.
Seven.
Yes, sir.
Eight.
Yes, sir.
Nine. 10.
Yes, sir.
11. 12.
Present, sir.
13.
Present, sir.
14. 15.
Present, sir.
16. 17. 18.
Present, sir.
19. 20.
Present, sir.
21. 22. 24.
Present, sir.
25. 26. 27.
Yes, sir.
28. 29.
Present, sir.
30.
Present, sir.
31. Present, sir. 32, 33, 34, 35, 34, Ashishwini.
She gave, no? What happened, Ashishwini? Sir, she's facing some network issues, sir.
Okay, no problem. 50. 50. 51, 52,
present sir.
53,
yes sir.
54, Chetana. 55,
present sir.
56,
present sir.
57, Manish. 58,
present sir.
59,
present, sir.
60.
Present, sir.
61.
Present, sir.
62.
Present, sir.
63. 64.
Present, sir.
65. 66.
Present, sir.
67. 68.
Present, sir.
69.
Present, sir.
70.
Present, sir.
71.
Present, sir.
72. Tejashwini. 73.
Present, sir.
74.
Present, sir.
75. 76.
Present, sir.
77.
Present, sir.
Okay.
Sir, 17 is present, sir. While I was telling attendance, the network disconnected, sir.
Number?
17, sir.
Seventeen. Okay, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, 13 present, sir.
13, aayta ma kottidini. Given.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Sir, 34 present, sir.
Na, yes, ma kottidini ma.
Boss, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, bye.